South African Book Development Council is once again traveling across the country, encouraging people to read more. They do this every year on National Book Week, and today is the fourth day of the initiative. Research shows that only 14% of South Africans are active readers, and only 5% of parents read to their children. So to tell us more, we are joined by Vista Kalipa from the organization. Vista, good to have you. Welcome to Morning Live.
Thank you, Leanne. It's good to be here.
Good. Now, all right, let's talk about the importance of reading. And I know we emphasize this all the time, but in your perspective, why should we read?
Oh, it is absolutely very important for people to read. I would like to emphasize, actually, particularly for young people, yeah, because those are obviously the future generation of our country. So it is important for them to start reading and taking that and making it a habit and incorporating it into their lifestyle, because reading actually really helps to mold the kind of people they are going to be in the future leaders of our country, the future business leaders, the future CEOs, and all of that. So with the reading, they get to gain insight, because it is the gateway to knowledge.
Yeah. You know, I had a wonderful conversation with, it was actually with, believe it or not, I think it was George Bezos. And he has very successful children, and his children have got successful children. And I was asking his one son, what is it? What do you do that has made your kids the success that they are? And he looked at me and he said, I don't know. All I can remember is I read to them. I read to them from the day they were born, and they just developed this love for reading, which made them want to succeed even more.
And they carried through their lives as they grow up. And hopefully it's something that they will also instill to their offsprings as well.
Yeah.
So it is quite important that parents start doing that at early stages.
It's sad that the numbers that we were talking about here, when I read the introduction, saying that only 14% of South Africans are actually active readers. You know, that's a worrying statistic. How are you going about trying to change the mindset of South Africans to say, guys, you've got to read more?
Well, actually, see, those numbers were based on a study that was conducted in 2006. Okay. And I mean, they still stand even today. So another study 10 years later was conducted last year, just to sort of gauge how we have fared since over the last 10 years. Has there been any improvements? Has there been any changes that we notice? So what we found is that actually, the numbers have grown to, so we've gained 1.1 million more readers since the time we launched the study. And so, but the only thing that has changed is that now people are actually spending less time reading than they did before. So now they spend about 4 hours a week like reading a leisure book.
Yeah.
So the initiative that the South African Book Development Council has started is National Book Week, which was a response to that 2006 study, to go around the country and just really increasing awareness about book reading, and also really trying to bring books to many South African homes as possible. Because we found that a lot of people actually cite, one of the reasons that they cited was that access to books was a challenge for them.
Indeed.
So this is what the council has been doing through National Book Week and other initiatives, is to bring books to people's homes.
And how do you go about doing that? I mean, where do you get the books from? How do you choose who is in need of these books?
All right. So the council itself comprises of a number of different people who range from, you know, paper manufacturers to book publishers, as well as our retailers. So we work in partnership with those people. So in particularly right now, we felt actually there needs to be an intervention that needs to be done right away. So we've partnered with a couple of retailers that sell books, such as your Exclusives Books, as well as our Bargain Books, to state that actually, how about we select a few books and we cost them at a 20 rand each. We put them in your books and put them in your bookstores, and then you sell them to the people, so that people do not complain and say that price of books is too high, and also we don't have access to books. So by actually lowering the price for this particular time and up until the 17th, we're able to bring books closer to people. And we're encouraging those who have the ability to do so, or the means to do so, to actually buy a book for another person and drop it in the book donation bin inside those stores, so that the books are taken to people.
Excellent. That is such a great initiative. What about access to libraries? You know, I mean, I remember, and we're always complaining about the cost of data, and we're complaining about everything online, which is expensive, and that's a battle that we're in currently.
Yes.
And a lot of people access books that way as well. But I mean, the traditional library where you can walk in, go in, sit down and read a book. I know in big cities you have beautiful libraries, but when you start moving out of the towns,
the scarcity of libraries.
That's the problem.
Actually, we're working also very closely with libraries as well. So the Library Association of South Africa, yeah. Those are our partners in this initiative as well, because they also need traffic coming through their libraries so that people are able to access books. Also in the rural communities, so you'd find that in certain towns where they don't have the actual facility of a library, so a library would be put inside a particular school so that the community can also come in and access that.
Yeah.
So those are some of the initiatives and programs that that we're working on to make sure people do get to books.
All right, so Vista, as you gave us a bit of a tip, that if we want to help in any way, it's buy a book for a buddy. So will we find them at exclusive books, at different book places where you can just buy something and drop it in there?
Yes, absolutely. So at the checkout counter, after you've just browsed through the store, and then you're at the checkout counter, you'll see there should be a display that states, buy a book, hashtag buy a book. Books are available for 20 Rand, and they also have pictures of the titles that are available for sale.
Okay.
And then you buy a book, and you please drop it in the book donation bin, and just let the next person have access to the book.
Fantastic. I think that's absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much for talking to us here on the program.
Right.
And I wish you the best of luck with this campaign.
Thank you, Leanne.
Just one of those figures we need to increase is that of only 5% of parents reading to their children.
Yes, we need more parents reading to their children, please.
Yeah, yeah.
As well as actually young people as well, reading to the elderly, because that's how we actually continue continue pushing the culture of reading in our country.
Indeed.
So we need to continue with that tradition and the storytelling tradition that we once had.
Yeah. Vista, thank you for talking to us here on the program. Vista Kalipa is from the organization. It's called the South African Book Development Council. So if you see one of those donate boxes next to the till wherever you are buying yourself a book, just $20, throw another book in there, why not? And you might be just giving someone else the ability to use their imagination and travel to places through reading that they would never have had the opportunity to do. Alright, let us wrap the show for this Thursday, and we'll see you again bright and early tomorrow morning. That's the Friday edition of Morning Live, but here we go. Let's leave you with Lunch Boy once again, some good old school music. Have a great day. God bless you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Family is a place where we have our most powerful bonds. But sometimes when there's a feud, these bonds can be tested.
Whoa, listen.
This is the show that takes therapy out of the consulting room and brings it to you, the people.